What's up, guys? Here we are on Wind Chaser, version 5.2 now. What I went and done is I added the damage mod. We have our 775E in the shop here, and you can see the HUD pops up. No damage. So we're just gonna back this rig in here. We're gonna lower a ladder. We're gonna lift this up. We're gonna open this door. Killer engine. So you can see the HUD pops up when you're in the trigger. Then we'll buzz on over to our new CT660 and give that a go. Roll down our window because that's what you're supposed to do. We got a little bit of damage here. I think it's 14% as it costs us 4,200, and it takes a little while to repair, I guess. So first time I'm ever using it, recording. So if something goes wrong, then we'll know what's going on. So as far as I could tell, that it only affects damage if you hit stuff or if you go. If it checks your XYZ and speed, so if you're going up and down a lot at a high speed, it doesn't really like that and it will cause damage. We'll go ahead and back our truck up. Another thing I did is I fully scripted this lift axle, so you see the airbags, even the airbags will kind of stretch, inflate and deflate, so that's pretty cool little feature. The ones on the sides do as well. You can't really see it, but anyways, I figured I was just gonna take this. We're at 0% damage now. I figured out my mirrors now. I figured out how to do mirrors correctly. So I figured that we would just drive around the map and see what kind of damage we get. So I'm coming in at like 25. So that was pretty nice. The map didn't really, the damage mod doesn't really seem to mind that. Getting my driver window down. And I can easily lower the passenger and get some breeze going through here, some virtual breeze. So we're cruising around in our new CT660. This thing's got like 500 or 600 horsepower or something like that. Turn on that massive J-breaker blinkers going here. We'll cruise on up to the neighbor's farm here. As fast as we can. So that map on the hill is actually buyable. You have to buy it now. Oh man! Almost hit that pole. Pretty sure that would have totaled our vehicle. Kind of ruined what I wanted to do. So we'll just fly on down here, check it out. Nothing's really changed here since I first started building this map. In fact, this is actually one of the first locations I started building, say, about a year and a half ago. At 0%, let's see what happens if we kind of go off crazy. Nothing. We come back on. There's 1%. So if we're driving like a tit, we are gonna get a little damage on the truck. So Jake's gonna be costing me money. What? What was that 4% for? That must have been like fast turning. I wasn't looking at the speedometer. I'm pretty sure we're turning like super sharp. So it doesn't like going over bumpy ground fast. It doesn't like sharp turns. Gotcha. We're cruising at basically 90 going down these roads here. This thing handles like a dream. Here, this is field 23 that we plowed up. See what happens if we go down this dirt road. 7%? It does not like those fast turns. I would have thought that it would like calculate damage based on hours. I'm really not sure. All I could see was like XYZ coordinates in the script, so I don't really think it goes off of hours. I think it just goes over speed and change in your planes, whether you go inside or minimum glare to the internal windows because that really bothers me, but exterior windows have quite a bit of gloss to it. I wonder what happens if we hit this. 12. Alright, so don't hit stuff. That's bad. I imagine that as soon as our damage gets up to like a certain amount that it'll be like reduced driving performance and stuff like that, so Anyways, there's town. There's the Amory. Now, I don't think I've ever showed you guys this before, and it's not on my leaked map. I think I put this in afterwards, but there we go. That's the official Amory, Wisconsin sign and Amory Water Tower there at the water treatment plant. I'm not sure if I showed you guys town since I basically finished the map, but it's kind of a confusing little thing. We got a few different bridges going through, some nice roads. We got lighting, we got a couple banks. There's where you sell your pigs. It also has sell points for milk, and that's where you sell your wool. And then started finishing up some lake houses. Started building a school that's going to add more lake houses. So, and then this is over kind of in the industrial park, so to speak. Here is where you can sell sand from the quarry, where all that smoke is coming from. You can at Semstone, you can load it up and sell it here. I never really messed around with that, but we got a grocery store in Menards where you can sell mulch. And that's about it. Then there's Field 20 right there, right behind Menards. We've never farmed that yet. Probably good. We're getting close because, I mean, we're at all the fields surrounding it, so we're finally swooping in on that. I have yet to farm that. You see the farm on the hill? That's now purchasable. All the farms on this map are now purchasable. You have to buy them, including the dairy farm over there, the big one, and then the shed's a little bit different. And this big grain operation, you have to buy that. It's all under one trigger, so everything's included. Same with the beef farm, you have to purchase that. You have to buy the bunkers, add the BGA. So this is a cool little field. I want to get over here and farm this field. That field looks epic. Just all these fields over here look nice. So yeah, that's pretty much it for over here. We're gonna hop right back in this truck and go haul ass. Gonna go up here. Gonna turn this back on so I can see where I get my damage. Speed limit 55. What can you do except go faster? Added in some different field entry points as well, like over here on the map, because there were none, so I just kind of added in some random. And that's a back road to the grain farm, aka it's kind of like a straight shot to get in. Oh, I must have stopped too fast to get or something. BGA also has you guys saw like Semstone in the quarry from the last videos. We're at about 9 ton. Or 9 kilogram. And 9,000 kilogram. We got a composter. Haven't used that. Pretty loud. Then we got dual BGAs so you can back in. And then we got silage mountains and all the bunkers that you need to buy and stuff like that. Oh man, we're slowly. See, we just stopped really fast. That's not like that. So I think I might have to adjust this slightly because I realize I'm driving pretty aggressively, but for the game purposes, it's too difficult to drive how you would in real life, like smooth and cautious. So, but I get it, we're gonna get wear and tear on these big trucks when we're going in and out of fields and up and down. So, I mean, maybe it'll just train us to drive a little bit more realistic, I guess, maybe a little bit more cautious of our speeds. You know, I'm going 40 on this road, and you know, you can probably go down a road like this, 45. So there's the big bee farm, you guys? Probably saw a lot of footage of that in old videos of when I was doing alfalfa and stuff. And then we got this big grain farm up here. That needs to be purchased. It's a 350,000 bushel grain complex. Big cement wash pad or parking pad or whatever you want. Nice scales. So that all needs to be bought. Then I added in this crazy awesome road here. It's got nice like curves to it and turns, and I really like this road. I really like how it spruced up this area here, and obviously we have a for sale sign out here, so I need to buy it. Sheep farms right there, that's where you get all your wool and stuff if that's what you're into. Add this dirt road over the bridge, paved all the way back here. Got some nice hog barns. These are some monster fields here too, if we ever get over here, which we will. Field 33 as well is also epic. So. This field right here, 33, when I sent Jake the 2100 Ripper like a year ago, he ripped this whole thing with the 9RT and the 2100. This is a bale sell point. This is where we sell all of our straw and bales. 37, this is the field that we're planting this year, so that's nice. Added all the power lines and it made the road a little bit straighter. So it likes these paved roads. I can go so that was under 20 and it didn't cause any damage. So and then over here is the lake homes, nice paved road, different power line structures. Meanwhile, the field is on our right. And then, got the big lake there with the hotel in the back. Background and lake country landscaping where you buy tree saplings and sell mulch and compost. Kind of see on the map where we are going around the big lake. And then we got our viable grain complex here. I think this is 90,000 bushel. Lumber yard. Let's see a train coming, so we'll just cruise over that. Long train. I forgot how many I added. It's either 60 or 70 cars I think I put on this train, so. Added power lines down this road too, so we'll That does not like when I brake fast. Had some power lines here and then the other side as well. So I just slam on my brakes. It's so weird. I can't make up its mind. Got our RPM and speedometer gauge going crazy. Nice rear view window, big window so we'd see what we're doing. Imagine if I hit these railroad tracks at this speed, it's gonna be damage. Nope. A few more houses coming up here. And then of course you got the modern large, I'll just get out here and pan out. Large, dairy farm, commodity shed, milking parlors, bale stall, buyable bins, and shed. Nice entry to these bigger fields out here, and some nice grassy pastures and stuff, and of course field 6 and 7 are also small and 10, so a lot of small fields here for a small dairy operation, and obviously you got access to big fields, so it's a pretty nice location for a map, but this map also needs to be bought, or this farm needs to be bought as well. Complex that needs to be purchased. And then these are the other power lines I was talking about. Finished all these. This bee farm, this more modern bee farm, also needs to be purchased. Field 16 is massive. I love it. This grain complex is 250 bushel, also needs to be purchased. Drive up here, this farm needs to be bought as well. Alright, so let's see what kind of damage we can actually get away with on this thing. Four. my brakes. Oh yeah. Slam on your brakes at that speed, you're gonna get some mad damage. So I have my truck completely pinned right now. As fast as I can go with 66. So it definitely affects your performance on your engine when you get up to these higher levels of damage. So I'm maxed out at 66. So let's see if we can ditch jump all the way back home. 73. So basically, take corners slower and don't go off of jumpy stuff very fast. Otherwise, I think I'll have to do a little bit of adjustment, because some of those, I was getting dinged for kind of ridiculous stuff. So. But I mean, you can go off of pretty aggressive stuff like this. Ooh, that one hurt. That's gonna hurt. Yeah. We're at 89%. Ouch. That's gonna suck ass. Anyways, hey, brought the truck back in one piece. Oh, that ain't... Wait, 28,000 in damages? For basically totaling this vehicle? Bump us down to about 6. So let's repair it. So this thing is getting repaired little by little. That's rather interesting how it calculates damage. So now I gotta wait like forever to get that thing healed, repaired up. Guess we can look at our beautiful shed here. You can see our ridiculous path of destruction. That's funny. Anyways, I pretty much drove around the whole map. I didn't get into all the details and stuff. Like, I don't know. I think you've seen it. If you watch my videos, you've seen enough of it, but. It's kind of interesting. I think you have to drive pretty recklessly, to be honest, in a truck. And I think you're going to get most of your damage in your truck and not your tractor, because your tractor can't go that fast. And that's where it seemed to get most of the damage, is going over and turning and stopping fast. Mostly, mostly turning fast. That I was getting hit pretty hard for that. Braking also abruptly, really fast. I mean, obviously. It's gonna be interesting to see if that kind of like exacerbates with any kind of weight on a trailer or something. But that's pretty cool that it's working and it's functioning and it's costing me money. And I mean, $28,000 to repair that thing. What was it, like 92% like totaled? I don't know. I would call that reasonable. I mean, the truck's like $120,000 truck. If the cost to replace it is totaled. This thing takes forever. Gotta love this mighty fine Meridian. Got some nice burned in chrome. Kind of makes me want to build a 2730. Got some nice expensive toys in this play shop. 8%. Awesome. I wonder if it has like a history for repairs. If it keeps a log or something like that. Yes! It is repaired! Alright, I wanna try it with this thing. Oh! Got a truck and trailer. This thing is fully loaded with seed. So what I'll do is I'll drive like I normally would and see what kind of like just normal wear and tear we would get. Say we're gonna go refill a planter at field 19 or something. Thank you. pretty safe to say that as long as you drive normally, we should be good. Then obviously if we go jump this off a cliff or something, so I don't know, I think it's probably okay. I was just driving pretty ridiculous with that truck. Anyways, I'm gonna call it a day. That was pretty fun. I'm pretty excited to see how this goes on the server. So, anyways, thanks for watching.